Good evening, everyone.
Good evening, sir.
I'm so glad to see all of you once again.
Also,
this evening we are going to share the Word of God.
I'm
sure that God is going to bless us with His Word. Okay, let us start our evening fellowship by the Word of Prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you. You have given us this precious evening. Even though now the whole world is in the chaos, but every evening you give us this chance to listen to the Word. I'm sure that as we listen to the Word, this Word will enable us to overcome whatever fears and worries, even the difficulties in our heart. In Genesis chapter 1, the very first book of the Bible, the earth was without form and void and darkness. However, when the word of God was spoken, then let there be light. Now there was a light. And when light came down this world, the darkness could not stay there anymore. In the same way, you continuously send us your word. Your word is the light. When this light comes inside of our heart, I'm sure that no darkness can stay in our heart. I'm sure that this evening also you will work samely. May you bless every the viewers and the followers. I pray everything in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Okay, so this evening let us open to the book of Jonah. Jonah chapter 4, from verse 1 through 11. If you have the Bible, please open to the book of Jonah chapter 4, from verse 1 through
11.
So I will read to you the book of Jonah chapter 4. But it displeased Jonah exceedingly, and he became angry. So he prayed to the Lord and said, Ah, Lord, was not this what I said when I was still in my country? Therefore I fled previously to Tarshish, for I know that you are a gracious and merciful God, slow to anger and abundant in loving kindness, one who relents from doing harm. Therefore now, O Lord, please take my life from me, for it is better for me to die than to live. Then the Lord said, Is it right for you to be angry? So Jonah went out of the city and sat on the east side of the city. There he made himself a shelter and sat under it in the shade, till he might see what would become of the city. And the Lord God prepared a plant and made it come up over Jonah. Then it might be shade for his head to deliver him from his misery. So Jonah was very grateful for the plant. But as morning dawned the next day, God prepared a worm and it so damaged the plant and that it withered. And it happened, when the sun arose, that God prepared a vehement east wind. Then the sun beat on Jonah's head, so that he grew faint. Then he wished death for himself, and said, It is better for me to die than to live. Then God said to Jonah, Is it right for you to be angry about the plant? And he said, It is right for me to be angry even to death.
uwiteka aramubaza ati ukoze neza uburakajwe nuko uruyuzi rwumye aramusubiza ati nkoze neza kurakara ndetse byatuma niyahura.
But the Lord said, you have had pity on the plant for which you have not labored, nor made it grow, which came up in a night and perished in a night.
Uwiteka aramubaza ati ubabajwe n'uruyuzi utinkingiye kandi utamejeje uruyuzi rwameze ijoro rimwe kurindi rukuma.
And should I not pity Nineveh, that great city, in which are more than 120,000 persons who cannot discern between their right hand and their left, and much livestock? When we read Genesis chapter 2, we can clearly see the beautiful relationship between God and the man. As you know very well, God created man. After God created the man, you know that he put his breath. It means that we humans, we received the heart of God. Now, Adam and the God's heart are connected in Genesis chapter 2. Therefore, when Adam was given this job to name the animals, now that whatever names Adam gave, you see that it pleased God. It clearly shows us that Adam, gave the names to each animal, by the wisdom of God. Even, when God, brought the woman, who are in need of Adam, Adam was very happy to have her. Which means that exactly the heart of God and the heart of Adam, they were connected. Now, this is the beautiful relationship between God and the man. God did not just create a man as a robot. And God does not just treat us as a slave. Therefore, God, he is not the dictator. God wants to pour his love to us. God is our Father. And God poured all of his heart and his love and his mercy on us. But this beautiful relationship was broken in Genesis chapter
3.
But when this beautiful relationship between God and man get damaged, we can see that Genesis chapter 3, now Adam and Eve, they listen to the voice of Satan, voice of a serpent. After they listened to the voice of serpent, they took the fruit of knowledge of good and evil. God said to Adam and Eve not to take the fruit of knowledge of good and evil. However, as they listened to the voice of Satan, now they took the fruit of knowledge of good and evil. It means that they had forsaken the word of God from their heart. What is the next after they took the fruit of knowledge of good and evil? Actually, before they took the fruit of knowledge of good and evil, they did not look at themselves. Which means, they followed the standard of God, they followed the rule set by God. However, after they took the fruit of knowledge of good and evil, they began to judge everything according to their eyes. Actually, God created them being naked, and it was no problem at all to the Adam and Eve. However, after they took the fruit of knowledge of good and evil, being naked became the big problem to them. And they tried to cover their naked body with the fig leaves. And they began to be afraid of God. They tried to hide themselves from the voice of God. Why? which because they look at themselves
kora kubirengeho
and they judged that they were not ready to stand before God
nuko banzura ko batitegwe kuba bahagarara imbere y'Imana.
Dear viewers, what is the biggest problem when we believe in God?
Mwese wakurikiye ese ikibazo gikomeye cyane mu gihe twizera Imana ni
iki? The biggest obstacle for us to believe in God, you see that is our own righteousness, our own judgment.
Inzitizi dukomeye cyane mu kwizera Imana ni uguca imanza kwacu n'inyanzuro dufata.
If you had the same standard with God, it would be very easy for you to believe in God.
Yego wagiraga ishingiro rimwe ry'Imana kwizera Imana byakakoroheye
cyane. The problem is when we read the Bible, we are able to clearly discover that our standard is different from the standard of God.
Ariko ikibazo ni uko dusubiye bibiliya dusanga ishingiro yacu bitandukanye n'ishingiro ry'Imana.
What is the salvation actually?
Ese agakiza ni iki mu gihugu?
Yeah, we can simply say that salvation is the forgiveness of sins.
Muri make dushobora kuvuga mu buryo bworoheje ko agakiza ni kubabarirwa ibyaha.
It is obvious that if you receive the salvation, you cannot remain in sin.
Ni bizwi neza ko mu gihe wakira agakiza udashobora kuguma mu cyaha.
You are no longer a sinner.
Ntubukimunyacyaha.
The Bible clearly says that there is no condemnation to those who are in Jesus.
Bibiliya ivuga neza ko abari muri Kristo Yesu nta teka bazacirwaho.
Problem is that many people, even though they say they believe in Jesus, but they remain in condemnation.
Ariko ikibazo nuko urwo rwose rwo kubizera Yesu bakomeza kwicira iteka.
The first of all, dear viewers, you need to understand the meaning of salvation.
Mbere na mbere mwese bakurikiranye mugomba kubanza kumenya ubusobanuro bw'agakiza.
Salvation means the remission of sins.
Agakiza bisobanura kubabarirwa ibyaha.
If you receive the salvation, it means that you should not remain in sin.
Wakira agakiza bivuze ko utakagombye kuba waragombye mu cyaha.
So by believing in Jesus, because Jesus came down this world for our sins,
kurako Yesu yaje muri isi z'ibyaha byacu,
and he was crucified at the cross to wash away our sins,
kandi yari kumusaraba kugira ngo yeze ibyaha byacu,
and Jesus never failed,
kandi Yesu ntiyigeze atsinda.
Therefore, if you exactly believe in this Jesus,
niba uvuga ngo usubize Yesu neza,
you have no choice but to become the perfect righteous before God.
Ntandi mahitamo ugira usibye kumukiranutsi utunganye imbere y'Imana.
You can never ever stand in sin again.
Ntibishoboka ko wakomeza guhagarara mu cyaha.
You can never ever have the condemnation in your heart.
Ntibishoboka ko wakwicira iteka mu mutima wawe.
Why? Because that is what Bible says.
Kubera iki kora kwicira icyo Bibiliya ivuga.
But problem is what?
Ariko se ikibazo ni iki?
According to your eyes.
Ugendeye ku maso yawe.
According to your feeling.
Ugendeye ku byo wiyumva.
You sometimes feel condemnation, right?
Rimwe na rimwe wumva wicira iteka.
And when you feel condemnation in your heart.
Igihe wumvise wicira iteka mu mutima
wawe. Even though Bible says there is no condemnation.
Nubwo Bibiliya ivuga ko nta gucirwa iteka kuri we.
You feel condemnation and you make a conclusion according to your feeling.
Uvuga uce iteka icyo gihe ugafata umwanzuro ugende ku kuntu wiyumva.
And you say that, oh, I have condemnation.
Ukavuga uti rero ndi kwicira iteka.
I have sin in my heart.
Mfite icyaha mu mutima wanjye.
This is how the people, they make a conclusion based on their feeling and their understanding.
Uku niko abantu banzura bashingiye ku myumvire yabo ndetse no ku mitekerereze yabo.
Dear viewers, you should know that this started from Genesis chapter 3.
Mwese wakurikiranye mukwiye kumenya ko ibyo byatangiriye mu itangiriro ry'ibice bitatu.
In Genesis chapter 2, that what God was pleased, it was something, it was what Adam was pleased.
Mu itangiriro ry'ibice bibiri ikiba nari yishimiye nacyo Adam yari yishimiye.
And what Adam likes, also it was what God liked.
Icyo Adam yakundaga nacyo Imana yakundaga.
But after Genesis chapter 3,
ariko nyuma y'itangiriro ry'ibice bitatu,
we can see that now we humans, we began to have a different standard from God.
Dushakora ko twebwe abantu twatangiye kugira ishingiro ritandukanye n'iry'Imana.
The Bible clearly says there is no condemnation to those who are in Jesus.
Bibiliya ivuga neza ko abari muri Kristo Yesu nta teka bazacirwaho.
However, now the people, when they feel the condemnation in their heart, they make a conclusion that they have condemnation in their heart.
Nyamara abantu bicira iteka kigibanzira yuko bacirwa iteka.
Ah, even though Bible says I have no condemnation.
Ati nubwo Bibiliya ivuga ko ntazacirwa iteka.
But I feel condemnation.
Ariko niyumva ko nicira iteka.
I think that I have condemnation.
Ntekereza ko nicirwa iteka.
I am true that I have condemnation.
Byanze ko nzi ubwo ndicirwa ho.
Ah, even though Bible says that all of my sins were paid by the blood of Jesus.
Nubwo Bibiliya ivuga ko ibyaha byose byishyura amaraso ya Yesu.
Even though Bible says that, that I become the righteous.
Nubwo Bibiliya ivuga ko nabaye umukiranutsi.
Even though Bible says that I have been justified.
Nubwo Bibiliya ivuga ko natsindishirijwe.
But I feel that I have sin in my heart.
Ndiyumva ko nkifite ibyaha mu mutima wanjye.
I feel that I still have the evilness in me.
Niyumva ko nkifite ibibi muri njye.
I don't think I become the righteous.
Sinibwira ko nabaye umukiranutsi.
I don't think I become justified.
Sinatekereza ko natsindishirijwe.
People make a conclusion according to their standard, according to their feeling.
Abantu bafata umwanzuro bagendeye ku ishingiro ryabo ndetse n'ukuntu biyumva.
It means that they live in Genesis chapter
3.
They live with their own standard. Dear viewers, suppose that you are wearing the red colored glasses. Once you wear the red colored glasses, everything will look with the red color. Why? It is not because of your eyes, but because of the red color glasses. Because of that, you have no choice but to see everything with the red color. In the same way, the Satan put the certain glasses on your heart. The glasses called your right thought and your feeling and your own standard. Even though God says that you are righteous, but you say that you are a sinner because you feel that you have sin in your heart. Is it true? Do you think it is true that Jesus failed to wash your sins?
But
Jesus never failed to wash away your sins. Jesus clearly said in the Bible, it is finished. All of your sins have been washed and paid by the blood of Jesus. This is what Bible says. And then, the true meaning of salvation is not just remission of sins. Let us open to the book of Colossians chapter 1. Book of Colossians chapter 1. Verse 13, the Bible says, He has delivered us from the power of darkness and conveyed us into the kingdom of the Son of His love. Verse 14, In whom we have redemption through His blood, the forgiveness of sins. Yes, in Jesus we are able to get this redemption and the forgiveness of sins. But when we read verse 13, we can clearly see how we changed our domain. So meaning of salvation is to change our domain. So He has delivered us from the power of darkness to the kingdom of the Son of His love. In other words, that God changed our domain. Some people said, I received the forgiveness of sins, that's enough. Now I have got what I wanted, that's enough. But the Bible clearly says, the true spiritual life, true salvation is to change the domain. We used to live in the power of darkness. Therefore, we have no choice but to live being influenced by the owner and the master of the power of darkness, which is Satan. However, after we receive the salvation, the forgiveness of sins, we are no longer under the power of darkness. Now we are under the power of Jesus Christ. If you live under the power of Jesus Christ, how can you live as you want? How can you live however you want? Some people said that, now you see that as all of my sins are finished, that's why I can live however I want. Even some people accused us saying that, you say that all of our sins are forgiven, that's why the people may think that they can live however they want. But if you are under the power of Jesus Christ, if you are under the power of the guidance of Jesus Christ, do you think Jesus lets you live however you want? That does not make sense. The problem is, people, they use their standard to judge the Word of God.
imanza ijambo ry'Imana.
They judge the word of God according to their rightful thought.
Ijambo ry'Imana barica imanza bagendeye ku bitekerezo byabo by'ukuri.
So as long as you hold your rightful thought, which is your standard,
igihe cyose ugundira ibitekerezo byawe by'ukuri ari naryo shingiro ryawe.
Even if you want to believe in God very well,
nawe ushaka kwizera Imana neza.
Even if you want to experience the great the works of God,
nawe ushaka kubona imirimo y'Imana ihambaye.
You cannot, you know, experience the works of God.
Ntabwo ushobora kubona imirimo y'Imana.
Why?
Kuki?
Because of your own standard.
Kubera ishingiro ryawe.
Therefore, true faith, you know, is started from the putting your rightful thought, your standard down.
Kwizera nyakuri gutangira gushyira hasi ibitekerezo byawe ndetse no kuri kwawe.
The book of Proverbs, chapter 3, verse 6.
Mu gitabo cy'Imigani 3:36.
The Bible says that acknowledge him in all ways and he shall direct your path. Acknowledge him in all ways. What does this mean? You know that sometimes that God may show you something good in your eyes. I'm sure that you are willing to receive it. And you are so grateful to have it. Why? Because that is what you want and that is what you like. But sometimes God may give you something which does not please you. Some difficulties. And some challenges. Something which does not look good in your eyes. At the time, so what would be your decision? Do you think you would receive it joyfully? Or you do reject it. Now we have the Bible in our hands. And the Bible is telling you each and every moment. And the Bible explains to us about our heart. But there are some verses which please us. Ah, you will get the victory. You will be the head, not the tail. People are willing to receive such word because it pleased them. But there are some verses which talk about your evilness, your true image. You are evil continually. Your heart is deceitful above all things and desperately wicked. And the people are not willing to accept that word. You know why? Because it does not match. It does not match with their heart. Even the issue of the salvation. Yes, people receive this message that Jesus is our Savior, Jesus died for our sins. However, when we say that Jesus died for all of our sins, once for all, perfectly, forever, now people easily agree that, ah yes, Jesus died for my sin in the past. However, sin in the future, it does not make sense. So can I commit the sin freely? People bring up with their objections. That objections are from where? And from what? From their own standard. See that many people follow their own standard. Today I read the book of Jonah. Now in Jonah chapter 4, I want to tell you that there are some things God prepared for Jonah. What is the first thing God prepared for Jonah? Let us go back to the book of Jonah chapter 4. Verse 6. The Lord God prepared a plant and made it come up over Jonah. God prepared a plant and it covered the Jonah, which means it protected the Jonah from the strong sunshine. That's why the Jonah was so happy. Now we can see the verse 6 that Jonah was very grateful for the plant. However,
Ariko,
now that God prepared the another things.
Hari ibindi bintu Imana yateguye.
What is that?
Ibyo ni ibihe?
The verse 7.
Umuntu wa karindwi.
But as morning dawned, the next day God prepared a worm, and it so damaged the plant that it withered.
Buke bwaho Imana itegeka inanda irya urwo ruyuzi bucya rwarabye.
God prepared a worm.
Imana yateguye inanda.
Now, and now this worm, you know, the ate all the plant.
Iyo nanda yari rwaruyuzi rwose.
That's why it, you know, withered.
Byatumye rwuma.
So the Jonah was angry.
How
come, you know, the God sent this worm?
Furthermore,
we can see the verse
8.
And it happened when the sun arose that God prepared a vehement east wind, and the sun beat on Jonah's head.
Maze izo rivuye Uwiteka ategeka umuyaga wotsa w'iburasirazuba, izuba ryicabena mu mutwe bituma yiheba.
Now we can see that, you know, though, there is a something that God, the Jonah liked.
Utorano ko ari ibintu Yona yakunze.
The plant.
Nkuruyuzi.
What about the worm and what about the east wind?
Now se inanda ndetse n'umuyaga wotsa w'iburasirazuba.
Now we can clearly see that Jonah, he disliked such things.
Ushobora kubona ko Yona atakundaga ibyo bintu.
Because of that, the Jonah became very angry, even he said until the death.
Icyo gice cyatumye Yona arakara ndetse akavuga ko yishakira gupfa.
At that time, God was asking Jonah,
icyo gihe Imana yabajije Yona iti,
is it right for you to be angry?
Ese koko urabona ufite ishingiro ryo kurakara?
What does that mean?
Ese ibyo ni ukuvuga iki?
It is not right for you to be angry.
Ni ukuvuga kurakara nabyo rwose nta shingiro bifite.
But problem is,
ariko ikibazo ni uko
Jonah, he was angry, you know, to the God, and he replied in this way.
Yona yarakariye Imana ni uko ayisubiza agira ati,
it is right for me to be angry to death.
Ni koko birambwiriye kurakara ndetse nabyo tuba ntiyabura.
What does this mean?
So
this means that the Jonah, he was holding his own standard, no, despising the standard of God.
So
let's think about that. You are standing on the court. Yes, you try to defend yourself. And, dear the justice, please, I didn't do anything wrong. Please, you made me innocent. I didn't do anything wrong. Now I am falsely accused. You please, madam, makes me innocent. I am innocent. Even if you speak this, you know, 100 times and 1,000 times, if the justice says you are not innocent, you are guilty, it means that you have to be sentenced. You have to be punished. Why? Because in the court, the most important is the judgment of justice. When you believe in God, what is the most important issue is the judgment of God. But many people, they don't care about the judgment of God. They value the judgment of theirs. The judgment of their feeling. In Genesis chapter 2, we couldn't find that. But in Genesis chapter 3, after we were deceived by Satan, now we began to have that judgment, our own judgment. Being naked is not good. Oh, now I am not ready to stand before God. That's why Adam and Eve, they were trying to hide themselves. They lived in fear. Yeah, no, we cannot find the fear in Genesis chapter 2, even though they were naked. Now the Bible clearly says, you are righteous, you are justified. This is what the Bible says. But so many people, they come up with their objection. I don't think so.
But this,
because I come to sin every day. How can man become the righteous? How can man become holy like God? It does not make sense. So many people, they live with their own standard. Dear viewers, if God says that you are righteous, what kind of the comment do you need more?
ese ni ikihe kindi ushaka kurenzaho.
If the justice, the highest justice says that you are justified,
ese umucamanza mukuru aramutse avuze ngo uratsindishirijwe,
what kind of statement do you need?
Ese ni imvugo yindi ukeneye.
You don't need any more statement.
Nta yindi mvugo yindi ukeneye.
Why?
Kuki?
Because the judgment of justice, the highest justice, that's enough.
Kubera ko umwanzuro w'umucamanza mukuru ungura hadije.
When you exactly believe in that, the word of God,
uramusezeye iryo jambo ry'Imana neza.
From that moment,
guhera umwanya,
you know, God is responsible for you.
Imana itangira kwiregera ibyaha.
We can see that Jonah was angry to God.
Dushobora kubona ko Yona yari arakariye Imana.
Because of what?
Kubera iki?
Because of his standard.
Kubera ishingiro rye.
Ah, I am right.
Rwose ngiye mukuri.
It is right for me to be angry even to death.
Rwose ngize neza kurakara byanatuma niyahura.
Now you see that Jonah, he did not put his right to thought down.
Turabona ko atigeze ashyira hasi ibitekerezo bye byo kwigira umuntu.
He did not forsake his own standard.
Ntabwo yaretse ishingiro rye bwite.
Even though he was used by God,
nubwo yakoreshwaga n'Imana.
However,
ariko
the book of Jonah, it is with only 4 chapters.
Igitabo cya Yona kigizwe n'ibice bibiri byonyine gusa.
But I want to compare this Jonah with the Jeremiah.
Ndashaka kugereranya Yona yo na Yeremiya.
I hope that you take your time to read the book of Jeremiah.
Nirije kwaza gufata umwanya ugasoma igitabo cya Yeremiya.
If you read the book of Jeremiah,
uramusoma igitabo cya Yeremiya.
Now these people, Israelites, they did not listen to the Jeremiah.
Abisirayeli ntabwo bumviraga Yeremiya.
Even they were against the Jeremiah so much.
Yeremiya baranamurwanyaga cyane.
But the amazing thing is,
gusigitangaje nuko
this book of Jeremiah, it is with 52 chapters.
Igitabo cya Yeremiya gifite ibice 52,
which means this book of Jeremiah is very much important book in the Bible.
Igitabo cya Yeremiya ni igitabo cy'ingenzi cyane muri Bibiliya.
That's why God spared 52 chapters for the Jeremiah.
Icyatumye Imana isigariza Yeremiya ibice 52.
Not many people listen to the word of Jeremiah.
Sabantu benshi bumvira ijambo rya Yeremiya.
But the amazing thing is,
gusigitangaje nuko
Jeremiah, he kept the promise of God in his heart and he kept speaking to the people from the prayer promise of God.
Yeremiya yabitse ijambo ry'Imana mu mutima we akomeza kuvuga ijambo ry'Imana.
I hope that all of our viewers, you speak after the word of God.
Abadukurikiye mwese ninjye kwajya uvuga bihuze n'ijambo ry'Imana.
If you speak after the word of God,
uramusuvuze bihuze n'ijambo ry'Imana.
Even though I feel that I am a sinner,
uti nubwo niyo umuhanda umunyacyaha.
But the Bible says I'm righteous.
Ariko Bibiliya ivuga ko ndi umucyaha.
Bible says I am holy.
Bibiliya ivuga ko nera.
Now you see that word of God will never betray you.
Iryo jambo ry'Imana ntirizigera rikugambanira.
That word of God will give you the new power and new energy and new strength.
Iryo jambo ry'Imana rizaguha imbaraga nshya ndetse n'intege nshya.
I really hope that this evening you receive the word of God and believing this message.
Kuri mugoroba rigiye kwa kwizera ijambo ry'Imana kandi ukizera ubu butumwa.
Thank you very much. I will speak up to here.
Ndashimiye cyane kasoreza.
Let us pray.
Dusenge.
Heavenly Father, we are in presence of you, Lord. We need your grace and mercy each and every moment. Father, without your grace and mercy, it is impossible for us to become holy like you, Lord. But you sent us your only begotten Son, Jesus. And Jesus died for our sins. Jesus shed all of his blood for our sins. And Jesus said, it is finished. After Jesus died, he was raised up. That was for our justification. This is what Bible says. How can we say that we are still sinners? If we say that we are a sinner, it means that, you know, that we agree with this thought that Jesus failed to wash away our sins. I hope that all of our viewers receive this word of God in their hearts, so that they can clearly see the works of God by this word of God. I pray everything in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you very much.
Murakoze cyane.
See you next time.
Naho gutaha.